get your ass up. This the Queen Quemo podcast, get your ass up. This the Queen Quemo podcast, get your ass up. This the Queen Quemo podcast. Look, 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 look. This the Queen Quemo podcast. Better get in tune when she broadcasts. Small feet. Better pay attention when she broadcasts. All facts. Might learn something with your dog ass. Get yourself checked on a Sunday. Just might get you right on a Monday. Aim high. Why? You can make it big someday. Cause when I say aim, I ain't talking about the gunplay. Even though we straight from the hood with it. Any topic we could talk was good with it. Yeah. Midwest, we putting on. You an artist in your song. Think your track hot, we gon' see when she put it on. They either gon' vibe or they gon' leave when she put it on. That's G, get to know about Queen. No subject, look, she just might open up. Not play this and freestyle when she open up. No play thing on the low, she be going nuts. Got the city going up. This the type of show you listen to when you're rolling up or chilling at the crib with your fam and y'all pulling up. Get some knowledge and a laugh on this podcast. Queen representing for the people on this podcast. Get some knowledge and a laugh on this podcast. Queen representing for the people on this podcast. It's the Queen Quemo podcast. Get your ass up. It's the Queen Quemo podcast. Look, get your ass up. It's the Queen Quemo podcast. Look, get your ass up. Nigga. Fat.
Hello, everybody. Today is November the 28th, 2023, and you're now listening to the Queen Quemo podcast. Shalom, salutations, assalamu alaikum, all of that good shit. Man, what the fuck is up, y'all? So, y'all know me, man. I be fried a little bit. I be smoking reefer or whatever. And so then I just get to thinking or whatever, and I be scrolling on my Facebook, and you know, it's now we in an era where everybody's very, very spiritual, and I'm here for it. You feel me? All praise be to God. I'm here for people becoming better and becoming more enlightened and more educated and doing things that's going to bring them peace with the whole mind, body, spirit, soul. You feel me? I'm all here for it. But let me tell you something. Listen, don't become so motherfucking spiritual that y'all become stupid. Because it be people will really try to argue you down. Like, yeah, y'all in this Bible, this white made Bible. Y'all in these Korans, y'all in these... Listen. I feel you. Everybody got a right and to feel how they feel, and y'all entitled to your opinion. But it's clear, it's real clear and real evident that you motherfuckers ain't never read no Bible or no Koran. Because when you're reading one or the other or both, you know that the fucking Bible... And I'm going to talk about the Bible in particular right now. And I'll talk about the other book in a minute. But the Bible be fucking spitting. The Bible be spitting, bitch. I don't know why y'all think that the Bible just a bunch of made up stories. It could be. You feel me? It could be made up stories. But listen, y'all be reading the motherfucking hood books and half of that shit be made up stories. Them urban books and them fiction books and them science books. And you motherfuckers say y'all love reading and y'all read all that shit. And it's fascinating to y'all. And y'all reading books about Kemen and Egyptology and Scientology. And that's interesting to y'all. And the books about astrology and witchcraft and all of that shit. And that shit is interesting to y'all. But baby, ain't shit more interesting than the motherfucking Bible, okay? Nothing. Them motherfuckers in that Bible. And Lord forgive me, I shouldn't be cussing. Let me stop cussing. Because I know some Christians listen to this. Y'all going to want to get on my ass. Yeah, I know. Tomato. Throwing tomatoes at y'all ass. Because half of you hoes judging me for how I talk need to really be judging yourselves for how y'all walk. And be hiding behind that motherfucking church. Because a lot of y'all is the reason why people don't believe in God. A lot of you hoes don't repent. But y'all want to dog people and then go to church and hide behind God. And like, yeah, because that's why I keep a clean hands and a pure heart. Yeah, bitch. Y'all ain't fooling nobody, hoes. We know about y'all. But anyways, because this is about the Lord and it ain't about you hoes, I'm going to have a little bit more respect and just tame my tongue a little bit. But anyways, the Bible be spitting, y'all. Listen, first of all, that a lot of that shit that's going on in that Bible is so relevant today. Like, the first fucking snitch was in the Bible. They was doing a lot of snitching in the Bible, okay? Let me tell you the first snitch. The first snitch was goddamn Adam, okay? So this shit, if y'all ain't paid attention to the Bible, if you ain't read the book of Genesis, go read the book of Genesis, man. You'll have a deeper understanding as to what the fuck was going on. So basically, God created the earth. you know, he started doing all his creations and stuff. He created mankind, you know, he created, you know, he did all his creations, you feel me? And so then he created my boy Adam, and Adam helped do a lot of the, you know, cultivation out here on the earth. He, you know, he helped God do his thing. And God seen that he was alone, and he said, it ain't good for a man to be alone. So I'm finna make you your flesh of the flesh, rib of your rib. So the first operation and clone was Eve. Eve was a clone. Eve was the first clone. Eve was a clone of Adam, okay? Eve was the first motherfucking clone, okay? So, all right, that happened, right? He do the operation. He make a clone. He make Eve. You feel me? Boom. They in the Garden of Eden. They chilling. They thugging. They doing everything they supposed to be doing. Now, we don't know exactly what happened because it's a lot of shit missing from the Bible, you know? It's a lot of stuff missing, but you can speculate and you can start putting two and two together and you can kind of see what be going on. So basically, you know, God gave the word to Adam. Adam gave the word to Eve, you know, chain of command. You feel me? He was in spiritual headship over Eve. So everything on earth, it was his rulership. He was ruling shit down here, Adam, you know. So long story short, him and his wife, they doing what they supposed to do. Eve, for whatever reason, started talking to the serpent. The serpent asked her on some messy shit. Like you know, this shit really just like a messy bitch from your neighborhood. Come up to you, ain't got nothing else better to do. Really be hating. They come up to you with some fucking drama. Come right up to Eve and be like, is it true that God said y'all couldn't eat from the tree of the garden? So here go this bitch, you know, she fall for the bait. She like, well, yeah, he said we could eat everything except for that tree in the middle. You know, now listen, y'all, look. It's not, I'm not quoting word for word what the Bible say because I don't have a Bible in front of me. But I do recommend that you read the book of Genesis and read it with open eyes and open ears and open mind. Go on and read the book of Genesis. You're going to see what's going on, right? But anyways, so, you know, the serpent asked her, is it true that God said that y'all couldn't eat from the tree? So she like, nah, he said we could eat everything except for that one in the middle. He said if we eat it, we're going to die. And then here go this messy bitch, the serpent. That motherfucker tells her, he know y'all ain't gonna die. He know the day y'all open that shit, y'all eyes gonna be open. So he said, you the day that y'all eat this tree, your eyes gonna be open and you gonna be like God. Now that was said in the Bible. He told her that when you eat that fruit of the tree, that you gonna be like God. That's why she ate. She wanted to be like God. She wanted to have some rulership. She wanted to be running some shit. You feel me? Now, we don't know the whole story and scenario, but we can see how that shit happened. Like, you know, people be always trying to, like, look for the problems and the shit that just don't make sense to them. But if you really look at it like some shit right now, in regular everyday relationships, what normally happens when black people got a business or black people start getting some money and they got a manager or something like that, the manager start getting greedy. The manager started getting jealous, or, you know, the people start getting jealous, so they start wanting the other person's position. You feel me? We see that happen all the time. So when we see this, we see she want to be like God. She like, shit, I want to be like God too. So she eat from the tree. She like, fuck this. I'm finna get this to my nigga too. Shit, we finna both be like God. Fuck you talking about? She take this motherfucking fruit over there to her nigga. They smoke it or eat it or whatever the fuck they did with it. And then when they get caught, this what he do. God get down on their ass. Because he like, you know, what the fuck y'all hiding from? Who told you motherfuckers y'all was naked? Y'all putting shit over y'all body and shit now. Who told y'all was naked? So that's how he know they did some shit behind his back. You know what I'm saying? He know anyway because he God. But that's how he knew, you know. And then here go this bitch ass nigga Adam. He like, yeah, you know, I only did it because that woman you gave me, she told me to eat it, so I ate. So God looking at him like, nigga, you bitch ass nigga, is she in charge or you in charge? I thought I put you in charge. How the fuck you let this woman tell you what to do? When I put you in charge, you the CEO of the company down there. How the hell you let the damn manager tell you what to do? So that's why I said sin into the earth through man, Romans 5:12. Feel me? Because had he corrected his woman, shit could have been differently. But he didn't correct his woman. He let his woman roll over him. So moral of the story is, look, read the Bible, y'all, and have your own opinion about a book that you actually read, that you actually took the time to read your own self before letting some of these fucking YouTube spiritual people and your fucking bitch ass uncle that just got out of jail a Muslim now. Don't let these motherfuckers trick y'all into believing some shit that they don't even really know for real is for real. Find out for yourself what the truth is. So pick up a Bible and pick up an actual Quran and read it for yourself. Read it for yourself, because the Quran is reciting the Bible. The Quran is the first five books of the Bible. Genesis, Exodus, Deuteronomy, Numbers, and Leviticus is recited in the Quran. It's recited in the Quran. You know, it's a lot of similarities in religion. You know, it's a lot of similarities. So I'm not telling y'all what to believe in. I'm not telling people, oh, you need to believe in God. But I'm just saying, like, if you don't believe something or you do believe something, you should do your own research to know what the fuck is up in there. Because the Bible be spitting. You hear me? The Bible be spitting. Like I said, like, okay, the Quran be spitting too. I'm not saying the Quran don't be spitting, because the Quran be spitting too. But I feel like the Bible just go more in depth, like, because it's more stories. You know what I'm saying? So, like, all right, second snitch in the Bible. Well, I ain't even gonna say snitch. The first raid in the Bible was Jesus Christ. The first raid in the Bible was Jesus Christ. Let me tell you something. Listen, if this shit don't sound like a raid, I don't know what do. All right, boom. So check this shit out. All right, so Jesus, he doing his thug dizzle. He out here preaching. He telling people the truth. It's like he going to get all his disciples or whatever. You know what I'm saying? It's like they gang banging or whatever. So he got all his disciples. They going out there. They like BMF. You feel me? Y'all seen BMF. They like BMF. And them other niggas is the 12th Street niggas, you know. I can't think of their names right now. Because, look, I'm a little rusty. What's their names in the Bible? The rabbis and them. So, the rabbis and them like the 12th Street niggas. And Jesus and them is like BMF. So, they got the city on lockdown. Jesus and them. Everybody just talking about Jesus and them. Man, y'all heard about Jesus? Man, that nigga Jesus, he out here healing niggas with his bare hands. Man, did y'all see Jesus' sandals? Man, that nigga Jesus fresh as hell. That nigga locks long as hell. Look, they just talking about Jesus because he just out here with good energy and good spirits, just healing the people, doing what the fuck he gotta do, taking care of his crew, his disciples, or whatever. He making sure all of them straight. He like, come here, folks. Your fucking feet dirty. Let me go on and clean your feet off. You feel me? He getting everybody together. Jesus getting everybody together. So like any nigga that got like good shit around their name, it's always a hating ass nigga on the sideline, jealous and spreading rumors about him and, you know, wanting to kill him and shit. So then, you know, the feds, they doing so much shit on the earth. They doing so much healing and so much exposing about motherfuckers being real and being fake. That's what Jesus and his disciples out there doing. When they doing so much of that, the feds get involved, right? The feds get involved. So what they do? When the feds start getting involved, what they do? They always find your weakest link in your crew. And in this particular situation, the weakest link in the crew was goddamn Judas. Judas was jealous. You know, again, to go back, look at all of these documentaries we got with the Temptations, New Edition, Selena. Shit, every time it's always the fucking manager that's jealous. They start getting jealous and they start doing some hating ass shit. But anyways, so what they do? They get Judas. They like, hey Judas, shit, what we gotta do to get you to turn in Jesus? He like, all right, well shit, I ain't gonna do it for nothing. Y'all gotta give me something. Give me 30 pieces of shekels. He said, I'll do it for 30 pieces of shekels. Y'all, he ain't gonna know it was me, is he? Like, no, we ain't gonna tell him it was you. All right, look, this is what we gonna do. When we get to the place, this how I'm going to let y'all know it's Jesus. I'm going to give him a hug and kiss him on his cheek. That's how you going to know it's him. Then y'all can just run down on him. They said, all right, boom. So Jesus, he could feel it in the air. He knew somebody finna cross him. He feeling it. His vital senses is on point. He like, man, I don't know what the fuck going on, but I know one of y'all doing some shit behind my back. And one of you niggas finna snitch on me. And they like, nah, not me, Jesus. I would never play with you like that. I'm your real nigga. I'm your best disciple. Especially Peter. Peter talking all this shit like he just the realest nigga in it. Which he was. But all of their ass did some fraudulent ass shit when it was time for go down. So like, Jesus, he just feeling in the air. He like, man, somebody finna do this, somebody finna do that. He telling. So anyways, they go down there to where they, you know, going to do they at the trap. You feel me? They at the trap. They doing what they gotta do. They doing their Jesus the nation business. You feel me? And then here come Judas. He come his bitch ass in. He come right up to Jesus. He like, what's up, Jesus? He like, what up, folks? How you doing? He like, shit, nothing. He give up to him. He give him a hug. He kiss him. And then boom, here come the feds. They try to get down on Jesus. So Peter, he was a real nigga. Peter see them try to get down on Jesus, y'all. And guess what Peter do? He take a motherfucking sword and he drah on a nigga ear. Cut the nigga ear off. Jesus such a real nigga. This what this nigga do. He like, man, nah, you live by the sword, you die by the sword. Nah, I'm gonna do my time like a real nigga. He picked the ear up, put it right back on that nigga head. Everybody really like, damn, even in his times of fucked up, this he still a real nigga. You feel me? So then they go to court. Jesus got an opportunity to testify, to give a statement. He got a chance to talk. He got a chance to say something, but what he do? He don't say nothing. He plead the fifth. He don't say nothing. So guess what his sentencing was? Death. Death. They sentenced my boy to death. You feel me? So he even died as a real nigga. That's the first ray. Like, what is y'all talking about the Bible born? Man, actually, get in that Bible, man. Get in that Bible. I'm sorry for cussing, Lord. You know, Lord, you know my heart. I ain't mean no disrespect. I didn't mean to cuss, but I had to speak in a language where people could understand because, listen, the Bible be spitting. It's so much stuff going on in that Bible. I don't know how people could say that the book is boring. It's not boring at all if you actually are a reader. And if you ain't a reader, listen to it in audio style. Take some notes. It be a lot of shit going on in that Bible. Because David, we ain't even going to talk about David. David was a motherfucker. He was real GD. That was big folks right there. King David. Oh, shit. David was a motherfucker. He was about that, though. He was about that. But he was in violation a lot. He was in violation a lot. Y'all, stop playing with my nigga, bro. Like, for real. Stop playing with my nigga. Like, stop playing with the Bible. Stop playing with the Bible. You cannot believe in Christianity or whatever. That's cool. You cannot believe. You cannot even believe in the Bible. But don't say it's boring. Don't say it's boring. Don't say it's made up. Because listen, a lot of that shit we going through right now here today. Right now here today. It's just a little bit different. Them scenarios, them two scenarios that I gave y'all was just two scenarios. It's hella scenarios that I and that's another reason how I know. That's why, shout out to the Hebrew Israelites. That's another reason how I know that book for real is about us, because it's just too much shit that's like relevant that to the ghetto that we understand. The murder of Abel, Cain and Abel. That's some real shit. How many stories y'all know from the hood where the brother killed the other brother because they was jealous? How many times y'all seen that? I done seen that shit even in my own motherfucking family. Not killing, but hurting, you know. But I'm just saying. Listen, read the books for yourself, y'all. Stop letting this new wave of spirituality have you on some monkey see, monkey do type shit. Nah, I believe in the Bible. I believe in the Quran. I believe in spirituality. I believe they all coexist with each other. I believe they all work together. That's my belief. It don't gotta be y'all belief. That's my belief, because I see the truth in it all. I see the truth in it all. If you choose to look for the truth, you're going to find the truth. If you choose to look for the lie, you're going to find the lie. And sometimes you might find both within each other. You might find the truth and the lie within each other. But do your research for your own self. Don't let nobody keep manipulating y'all into what you should and should not believe. And because half of these people that's trying to manipulate y'all into what you should and should not believe have not actually did any investigation on their own fucking beliefs. They don't actually stand 10 toes down on their own motherfucking beliefs. Don't listen to these folks, y'all. Learn for yourself. Learn for yourself. Learn for yourself. That's all I got to say about that. But yeah. I ain't gonna go all over y'all here with this shit. This episode is real simple and sweet. I just want to encourage y'all to read the Bible and read the Quran. And if you into spirituality, I want you to do your own research. Don't be just burning motherfucking sage because you seen a bitch on Instagram burning sage. You ain't got to burn no sage, bitch. What you burning sage for? You don't got to burn no sage. You can burn sage. But shit, some of y'all don't need to burn sage. Some of y'all just need to get some bleach and clean your motherfucking house. And the spirit will be gone. You feel me? I hate to say that, but I got to be 100 with y'all right now. That's just all you need. That's all you need, bitch. You don't need sage. You need bleach. You need to clean your house. You need to get all them toxins out your house. The dirt. Maybe you need to boil cinnamon. You know, maybe you need some lemons. You know, if you really in a natural community and you don't want to use no chemicals, you can use lemons and salt to get rid of the toxins in your house. You know, lemons and salt. Maybe that's what you need. Don't take what somebody else do and think that's what you got to do. Do your own research. Because half of these folks ain't got no real beliefs. Half of these folks ain't even got no good relationship with God. They ain't got a good relationship with their goddamn self. Pay attention to the people that's talking to y'all. Look at the relationship they got with they self. Look at the relationship they have with their family and friends. Do you really want to be following them and listening to them and monkey see monkey doing? Fuck no. I don't. Shit. I'm going to do my own investigation and research. I'm going to investigate and see what works for me. You know, and that's all I want to encourage people to do. Don't follow me. Do your own investigation and research is what works for you because I'm still learning my damn self. But one thing I know for sure, goddammit, is that the Bible ain't boring and I stand on that. It is not boring. It's so much going on. It's only boring. Well, okay, let me not lie to y'all. Okay, certain parts is boring. Like the books of Numbers is boring to me. The books of Leviticus is boring to me. Deuteronomy is boring for me. Those is like the policy and procedures of the Bible. That's like the policy and procedures of the Bible. Like, who want to read policy and procedures? I mean, if you like that, cool. You might enjoy that. You might really enjoy learning the structuring of that. But shit, I don't have no desire for that. But like, the rest of them, real interesting. Even the book of Proverbs, real interesting. That's like, shit, like the, what's that like? That's like the metaphors of the Bible or some shit. Like, I don't know. It's like that, though. It's like a poetry part. Like, it just make you think, you know. I guess it's, is that a metaphor? Yeah, like metaphorically. It's like metaphorical part of the Bible. But listen, do your own research, man. Stop letting people make y'all not read a book that you ain't never read in the first place. And that's a whole nother thing. Because y'all be talking about, I just stopped believing in the Bible because, when I got older. Bitch, how could you believe in something you never read? So just because your mama was a Christian and your mama went to church and now you don't fuck with your mama, so you don't fuck with church. They ain't got nothing to do with God. You know, they ain't got nothing to do with God. Don't let these hypocrites turn y'all off from God, man. God is real. And I know it be hard sometimes because it do be a lot of hypocrites and they be thinking they fooling God. They not fooling God, baby. They not fooling God. They doing their job. They doing their job. They dare to distract people from God. They doing their job. They not of God. They of the devil. And they doing their job. So you got to let them do your job. And you got to let God do his job. And you do what you need to do for you.
Yeah. Hey. Come on. You ain't ready for the comeback. Black man to the dirt. I'ma hit him where it hurt. Better run that. Black man to the dirt. I'ma hit him where it hurt. Been a minute since I've been up in the spotlight, but I bet that I can still move the crowd. True definition of an MC, if you don't agree, then you need to move around. They be like, Black, you gotta give the people what they want. I be like, man, that's garbage. What you need to do is stay true to yourself. If you dope, then they gon' rock with you regardless. I'm a little old for the milli rock, but I guarantee my popularity will still increase. If you want sauce, then you need to take a trip to the city, go to Hell Chicken, pick up a 6-piece. Everybody anticipating on the return of Black. Once a minute, they don't turn it back. Nothing but burn the tracks and turn their stacks to a meal ticket. Ain't no way you finna deal with it. Ain't no such thing as a new me. Ain't another man that can do me. Forever I'ma represent 2-3. Thinking I'ma fall, you a goofy. Ain't no such thing as a new me. Ain't another man that can do me. Forever I'ma represent 2-3. Thinking I'ma fall, you a goofy. Get ready for the comeback.
Jordan 45, Jordan 45.
Get ready for the comeback.
Jordan 45, Jordan 45.
When you see me, better run that.
Jordan 45. 45, Jordan 45.
When you see me, better run that.
Jordan 45, Jordan 45.
Yeah. Everybody thought that I was done, hoping I had nothing left to show. I was forced to take a crucial break to make sure that my ducks was in a row. You would never make it in this game unless your normal life is good to go. Now I'm back on the scene and the crowd loves it. Give me the